That was my back, not the microphone. I would like to call to order the March 25 meeting of the Newport Beach City Council. And would announce that we are going to be going to closed session, but would like to have public comments for closed session first, right after the roll call.
The record will reflect that all members of council are present.
All right, then I would ask for public comments on the closed session. Yes, sir.
Mayor Hill and members of the council, my name is Jim Mosier. The very few members of the public who attended yesterday's Finance Committee meeting heard an interesting discussion of what are called the city's discretionary reserves, with a view, I think, towards clarifying if the city is indeed sitting on an immense pot of funny money that we have available to fund things like the Newport Beach dividend, water taxes, and other new projects, or if to do so would mean that we would have to forego other things that we have already planned to do. One category of discretionary spending that I did not see clearly delineated is the amount we hold in reserve for the legal battles we choose to fight. And it looks like you have one of those decisions before you tonight. By way of background, and since I think you know this, I'll be brief. In 2008, the city passed a novel new ordinance to regulate group homes. Two of the rehab operators sued us in federal court, claiming that we were discriminating against them. Our legal team chose to make its usual opening move of declaring the suit to be without merit. And surprisingly, the trial judge bought that argument and tried to dismiss the case, but the rehab operators chose to go to the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals, and you apparently directed our staff to spend money defending against that appeal. By the luck of the draw, the appeal was heard by three of the more liberal judges, and last September, they issued a blistering attack on our city, saying there was indeed enough evidence for a trial to go forward. In response, you apparently authorized spending still more money to ask for a rehearing by a larger group of Ninth Circuit judges. On March 4th, that request was denied. However, four of the more conservative judges issued their own blistering attack on what they saw as the wrong-headed reasoning of the three who said that the trial should go forward. Tonight, I suspect you may be asked to authorize spending still more of your constituents' money appealing the denial of the rehearing to the U.S. Supreme Court. After all, four judges siding with the city and only three against us makes it sound like the Ninth Circuit might be closely divided on this. I wanted you to be aware that there are 29 judges in the Ninth Circuit. So by their silence, there could be as many as 25 who think that it's a slam dunk, that there's reason for a trial, and only four who don't. I believe prudence suggests that we should accept that there will be a trial and save our discretionary funds to put on the best defense we can, or alternatively, completely swallow our pride and ask ourselves if our ordinance does indeed need some tweaking, like our adjustments to the Harbor Code, and that might be the least costly way to defuse a very costly situation. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any other individuals that would like to make comments at this point in time? Seeing none, then, Mr. City Attorney, do we have reason for a closed-door session?
Yes, we do. The City Council will adjourn to closed session to discuss item 2A on the regular agenda. A conference with legal counsel regarding the litigation involving Pacific Shores and Newport Coast Recovery.
All right, thank you. Then we stand adjourned until 7 p.m.